Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how to place objects in Mac apps with precision. Now, when working in graphics, word processing, or design apps, you often need to place objects at different places in the document. For instance, you may drag and drop an object on one side of the screen or the other. It's easy to place objects in the general area where you want, but if you need precision, it can be tougher. But there are a variety of techniques that let you place objects exactly where you want them. However, if you don't have a background in design or desktop publishing, you may not know about these, even though they've been around for decades. Now, the techniques I'm talking about are not the snapping techniques that you probably are familiar with. Like, for instance, these objects can easily snap to center with each other, like this, or align the edges like that. And you can even, in apps like Pages, show rulers, create guides, snap objects to guides, and all of that. But I'm not going to talk about that kind of placement. I'm going to talk about things that will work without setting anything up in advance. So for instance, when you place an object like this one, and you want to get maybe these two points to touch like that, just as an example, you may have a hard time trying to drag and drop to that exact location. What a lot of people don't realize is you can simply stop dragging and dropping, and for precision, use the keyboard. The arrow keys on the keyboard will take what is selected in almost any app and move it one pixel at a time. So you could see how I can move it slightly and get it pretty much exactly where I want. Now, another aspect of this is that it's pretty slow, right, to move one at a time. But in almost all cases, in all apps, if you hold the shift key down and use the arrow keys, it moves in larger increments, usually 10 pixels at a time. So to the left, one pixel at a time with the left arrow key, but shift and left moves 10 pixels at a time. This works the same in Keynote. If I select an object in Keynote, the arrow keys move the object one pixel at a time, shift and arrow keys move the object 10 pixels at a time. Here's a freeform. I select an object and I can use the arrow keys for one pixel, shift arrow keys for 10 pixels. Here's preview. In preview, usually just read documents, but you can turn on the markup tools and then create shapes and objects and text and things like that there. And with an object selected, I can use the arrow keys to move one pixel at a time and shift with the arrow keys to move 10. And finally, here's an example of a third-party app, although Pixelmator Pro is owned by Apple now. But you can select an object here, and the same thing. You can move one pixel at a time with the arrow keys, and shift and arrow keys moves in larger increments. Now, you may already know that, and that's fine, but I know there's a lot of people that just never think of actually moving to the keyboard to move one pixel at a time like that. And as you can see, it's something that's been adapted by almost all apps, Apple's apps and third-party apps. Anywhere you drag items around in a document, you usually can use the arrow keys and shift plus the arrow keys to move them around with precision. Now, here's another technique you'll find in almost all apps. You can use alignment tools to move things around. So for instance, if I wanted to get these to align with each other, I've got this handy little snapping tool here in Pages. But if you don't want to rely on that, you could always select multiple objects like that. Then usually in the menu called Arrange, you'll find Align. And here you can align the objects in different ways. Left, center, and right, that's for the position horizontally, and top, middle, and bottom is for the position vertically. So for instance, if I do middle, the middles of these objects will align. And it doesn't matter how many objects I have, so I can have a whole bunch more like this, and I could select them all like that and go to arrange and then align objects and then middle. And now they're all arranged so the centers all match. And usually you have other options, like I could have the tops of the items all match like that. And as you would expect, you find the same thing here in Keynote. I'll align objects and then do it with the centers here. Notice the positions now. And when I use center, it basically gets the average of all of those and puts the objects aligned with that. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MacMost through Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. But look what happens when I have a bunch of different objects. In general, it should take the center between the rightmost and leftmost objects and then use that as the location. And here I am in freeform, and you could find the same thing here. But unfortunately, here in preview, you don't have any arrangement tools. Now, another thing the arrange menu does in most apps is if you select multiple objects, you, instead of aligning objects, can distribute them. So that will space them evenly, either horizontally or vertically or both. So I can have them distributed horizontally, evenly, like that. It recognizes there's four objects and will put the centers of each of those objects an equal distance apart. And you'll find the same thing here in Keynote. Notice it's still using the leftmost and rightmost object to get the left and right sides of this, and then it's arranging everything between that. So you notice the leftmost and rightmost object don't move at all. It's just the other objects that then are evenly distributed. And you'll find the same thing here in Freeform and here in Pixelmator Pro as well. It even gives you more options here. So you can distribute based on the top edges, bottom edges, left edges, or right edges, in addition to the centers. Now, even if you knew about those previous two techniques, I find a lot of people don't know about this one. And it's been around literally since desktop publishing apps in the 1980s. If you are dragging something around and there's snapping involved, like your pages is going to try to snap to the centers of things, other apps may have grids and guides that it snaps to. You can go into the preferences and settings and turn off all the snapping if you want to place with precision. Or you can simply hold the command key down when dragging. So look what happens here. If I'm dragging normally, you can see how it's snapping to the tops, the bottoms, the centers, everything. But if I just hold the command key down while dragging, that goes away. And suddenly it moves fluidly without the snapping. So if I want to place it, say, just above this, but that's not quite right, I can just hold the command key down and place it exactly where I want. And this works in so many apps. Here I am in Keynote, and holding the command key down now suddenly gets rid of all the snapping. Here I am in Freeform, and I even have it snapping to the grid here in Freeform, but if I hold the command key down, suddenly it's no longer snapping to the grid or other objects. Here in Pixelmator Pro, the same thing. It snaps to guides, it snaps to grids, it snaps to other objects, but holding the command key down makes that all go away, and you could place something exactly where you want it. And yes, even in preview, this works. Notice how that this snaps to the other object to align. But if I hold the command key down, that goes away and I can place it wherever I want. This is the very technique that inspired me to do this video. A lot of people don't know the command key is almost universal through all Mac apps in ignoring the snapping and grids when placing objects. It comes in very handy and I use it every day. Now, the one last technique I want to show you is another one that some of you may know and others may not. And it's simply that you can type exact numbers to place things. So yeah, you could drag around and yeah, you can use the arrow keys. But here in Pages, if with an object selected, you go to Format, Arrange, you actually have position here and you could set the position to an exact number. So in this case, the Pages document is set to use inches. So I could set it to exactly 2 inches. I can use these little arrows to move it around. I can have it be precise, like 2.01, like that. And the numbers that are used, if you don't like inches, you can change those by going to Pages, Settings, then look under Rulers, and you could set the ruler units to points. And notice now that it's set to points, and you could change the exact point location for every object. And you could also change the size of objects too. So when it comes to dragging to resize something, you can use this and actually change the numbers to get exactly what you want. And as you probably guessed, it's the same in Keynote. You can move objects around, then go to Format, Arrange, and you've got position and you've got size, and you could set those numbers manually to what you want. As you can imagine, Pixelmator Pro has this as well. You need to be using the arrange tool here. So if you're like you're in the paint tool, you won't see it, but in the arrange tool, you'll see size and position. And you could set that to precise locations for different objects. Sadly, however, Freeform doesn't have the ability to do that. You see the X and Y location as you're dragging, and using the command key, you can kind of place things exactly if you're patient, but there's no place where you can actually edit the numbers. And the same for preview. There's no place here where you can edit the numbers. You can't even see the numbers. So if you want to place something with precision here, you really need to get it as close as you can by dragging and then use the arrow keys. So if you want to place objects precisely in apps on your Mac, learn those four tools. Use the arrow keys, use the arrangement tools to align and distribute objects, use the command key to circumvent snapping, and look for ways to set the exact X and Y position of objects in the app you're using. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.